Multilingual celebration on the eve of World Poetry Day, tomorrow, March 21st, 2024. World Poetry Day supports linguistic diversity through poetic expression and means to offer all voices and tongues the opportunity to be heard. In this spirit, we have been encouraging a linguistic spectrum of 10 languages for our evening together. These are in the order in which they first appear on your program: Spanish, German, Arabic, Turkish, Chinese, Portuguese, French, Italian, Swedish, and believe it or not, English. In an overwhelmingly monolinguistic academy in our day and age, where tokens of exchange and flattened abstractions reign supreme, a plea for multilingual poetry as one concrete, universal, and powerful venue for our shared world's vernacular diversity seems apropos. In touch, as the world's languages are, with their respective cultural grounds and backgrounds. World Poetry Day celebrates poetry as one of humanity's most treasured forms of cultural and linguistic expression and identity. Poetry has been practiced in every culture and every continent throughout history and speaks to our shared humanity, vulnerability, and precarity. Our evening together capitalizes on this insight with our focus on poetry written in and or about displaced existence, be it by way of exile or imprisonment, expulsion or incarceration, in prisons or closed medical institutions, beyond cities or countries changing borders, or on faraway islands. Almost two decades ago, I taught at Bilkent University in Turkey. Bilkent offered a celebration of World Poetry Day 2007, my first exposure, a time when I first heard live Farsi, as emphasis was placed on Rumi, the 13th century poet and scholar of Islam. Farsi was followed by Turkish, then English. I understood some, let's say little Turkish, but positively no Persian, but have very fond memories, particularly of the sound of Persian. Every poem and song tonight will be rendered in at least two languages. English is always one of them, since we do want to provide access by way of translation. At the same time, however, we'd like sound, the sound of the music, as well as the sound of the poems read, particularly perhaps when they are read and sung in languages one might not understand. In that spirit, we are not projecting the lyrics this year, we are going to project artwork instead. More than an evening featuring poetic expertise, this event sets out to be a celebration. This does not mean that there is no expertise. Rather, it means that we have, over the years, repeatedly envisioned this gathering as a venue for languages to be read, also by people who are not native speakers, but have made great efforts to acquire another language, or even languages. Our readers and singers range from first-year language students to published poets, and from our university's faculty and Fulbright fellows to our guest today from Penn State, professor and soprano Jennifer Trost. I would like to thank everybody who is here for coming, for participating. I would like to thank our students and my colleagues for joining me in this collaboration. And I would like to thank everybody for having taken the time to carve out the space on a very busy calendar, all of which was needed to make this happen. I would like to thank Julie Box and Sarah Jöseles for all their help with all kinds of practicalities, including their fabrication of our poster. Special thanks to Isabel Galliera, who compiled the images that will be playing in the background of prison scenes. While free people who have not experienced imprisonment or exile must be careful, I would suggest, to use these terms metaphorically, not metaphorically, without a second thought. Not to succumb to romanticizing displaced existence as a favorable condition for creative action. Some have gone so far as to render various meanings of concentration synonymous. It seems nonetheless important to consider poetic writing in prison and exile as an energy that at least momentarily has managed to transcend what Michel Foucault famously calls discipline and punish in his analysis of modern incarceration. Philosopher Socrates wrote in prison, and poets Ovid and Dante in exile, on the Black Sea, and anywhere in the Romance territory but Florence, respectively. Paul Laurence Dunbar, born to enslaved people, knew why the caged bird sings. And Maya Angelou did too, who borrowed his title. German-Jewish psychoanalyst Edith Jacobson wrote German poetry during her incarceration in Nazi Germany, before her flight to New York City, stressing that only these songs could confront her fear and pain. Turkish poet Nazım Hikmet spent most of his life in prison, including Moscow and Bursa, and wrote almost all of his poetry in captivity. Alda Marini, too, wrote most of her verse in a closed institution in Milan, while Ezra Pound, who ended up at St. Elizabeth's Clinic in D.C., was previously imprisoned in Italy, where he read birds on electrical wires that he saw outside of his cage near Pisa, and imagined these birds as musical notation, trying to sing their melody. Welcome, everybody, and thank you for joining us for When the Caged Bird Sings. Stage, but we especially need Christian, who's going to read her, and also Ethan or whoever is going to replace.
Los exiliados. Los exiliados persiguen por las calles sombras antiguas, retratos de muertos, voces balbuceadas, hasta que alguien les dice que las sombras, los pasos, las voces son un truco del inconsciente. Entonces dudan, miran con incertidumbre y de pronto echan a correr detrás de un rostro que les recuerda otro antiguo. No es diferente el origen de los fantasmas. Hablamos lenguas que no son las nuestras. Andamos sin pasaporte, ni documento de identidad. Escribimos cartas desesperadas, que no enviamos. Somos intrusos numerosos desgraciados, sobrevivientes, supervivientes. Y a veces eso nos hace sentir culpables.
They trace through the streets, ancient shadows, portraits of the dead, stuttering voices, until someone tells them that the shadows, the footsteps, the voices, are a trick of the unconscious. Then they hesitate, look with uncertainty, and suddenly they start running, after a face that reminds them of another ancient one. The origin of ghosts is not different. We speak languages that are not our own. We walk without a passport or identity document. We write desperate letters that we don't send. We are numerous, unfortunate intruders, survivors, and sometimes that makes us feel guilty.
Exil, ein Toter bin ich, der wandert, gemeldet nirgends mehr, unbekannt im Regiesbefekte, überzählig in den goldenen Städten und im grünenden Land, abgetan lange schon und mit nichts bedacht, nur mit Wind, mit Zeit und mit Klang, der ich unter Menschen nicht leben kann. Ich mit der deutschen Sprache, dieser Woche um mich, die ich halte als Haus, treibe durch alle Sprachen. O wie sie sich verfinstert, die dunklen, die regen Tone, nur die wenigen fallen. In herre Zonen trägt dann sie den Toten hinauf.
Exile. I am a dead man who wanders, registered nowhere. Unknown in the prefect's realm. Unaccounted for in the golden cities and the greening land, long since given up and provided with nothing, only with wind, with time, with sound, I who cannot live among humans, I with the German language, this cloud around me, which I keep as a house, press through all languages. Oh, how it grows dark, those muted, those rain tones. Only a few fall into brighter zones. It will lift the dead man up.
An den kleinen Radioapparat, du kleiner Kasten, den ich flüchtend trug, dass seine Lampe mir auch nicht zerbrechen. Besorgt von Haus zum Schiff, von Schiff zum Zug, dass meine feinen Worte zu mir sprechen. An meinem Lager und zu meinem Heim, der letzten Nachts, der ersten in der Früh, von ihren Siegen und von meiner Ruhe. Versprich mir, nicht auf einmal stumm zu sein. To the little radio. You little box that I carried as I fled, concerned to save its works from getting broken. Cared for from house to ship, from ship to train, so that my enemies could still speak to me. At my bedside and to my pain, the last thing at night, the first thing in the morning, could still speak to me about their victories and my efforts. Promise me to not suddenly go silent.
Die Flucht. Auf der Flucht vor meinen Landsleuten bin ich nun nach Finnland gelangt. Freunde, die ich gestern nicht kannte, stellten uns Betten. In sauberen Zimmer, in Lautsprecher, höre ich die Siegesmeldungen des Abschaums. Neugierig betrachte ich die Karte. Hoch oben in Lappland, nach dem nördlichen Eismeer zu, sehe ich noch eine kleine Tür.
The flight. In my flight from my countrymen, I have gotten as far as Finland. Friends, whom yesterday I did not know, gave us beds in clean rooms. On the radio, I hear the war reports of the scum. Curiously, I look at the map. Way up in Lapland, towards the Arctic Circle, I see a little door.
Speisekammer 1945. 42. O schattiger Quelle, eine dunkle Tanne, ich geht nächtlich brausend in dich ein und mischt dich mit der süßen Milch aus großer Kanne und dem des Wurzelspecks am kalten Stein. Bier, Ziegenkäse, frisches Brot und Bier, geflut am grauen Straub, wenn Frühtau fällt. O könnte ich laden euch, die über Meere der Krieg der Leeren wegen hält.
Larder, 1942. O shadowy coot coolness, the scent of a dark fir tree comes nightly swirling in, and mixes of that of sweet milk from a large churn, and of the smoked bacon on the cool rock, beer, goat's cheese, fresh bread, and berries, picked from the gray undergrowth when the dew falls. If I could invite you, who across the sea have empty stomachs from the war.
Strauch, dein Frühtau fällt. Oh, Angina pectoris. Yarısı buradaysa kalbimin, yarısı Çin'dedir doktor. Sarı nehre doğru akan ordunun içindedir. Sonra her şafak vakti doktor. Her şafak vakti kalbim Yunanistan'da kurşuna diziliyor. Sonra bizim burada mahkumlar uykuya varıp revirden el ayak çekilince kalbim Çamlıca'da bir harap konaktadır her gece, doktor. Sonra şu 10 yıldan bu yana benim fakir milletimi ikram edebildiğim bir tek elmam var elimde, doktor. Bir kırmızı elma, kalbim. Ne arterios geloros, ne nikotin, ne hapis. İşte bu yüzden, doktorcum, bu yüzden bende bu angina pectoris. Bakıyorum geceye demirlerden ve imam tahtamın üstündeki baskıya rağmen kalbim en uzak yıldızla birlikte çarpıyor.
Angina pectoris. If half my heart is here, doctor, the other half is in China with the army flowing towards the Yellow River. And every morning, doctor, every morning at sunrise, my heart is shot in Greece. And every night, doctor, when the prisoners are asleep and the infirmary is deserted, my heart stops at the rundown old house in Istanbul. And then, after 10 years, all I have to offer my poor people is this apple in my hand, doctor. One red apple, my heart. And that, doctor, that is the reason for this angina pectoris. Not nicotine, prison, or arteriosclerosis. I look at the night through the bars, and despite the weight on my chest, my heart still beats with the most distant stars.
Angina pectoris. Wenn die Hälfte meines Herzens hier ist, Doktor, ist die andere Hälfte in China, bei der Army, die hinab seit dem gelben Fluss zu. Und an jedem Morgen, Doktor, an jedem Morgen, wenn es dämmert, wird mein Herz in Griechenland standrechtlich erschossen. Und hier bei uns, wenn die Gefangenen einschlafen und im Revier sich alles zur Ruhe legt, halt mein Herz in einem verfallenen Konak in Chamlicha, Doktor, jede Nacht. Und seit diesen 10 Jahren, Doktor, habe ich einen einzigen Apfel in der Hand, den ich meinem armen Volk anbieten könnte, einen roten Apfel, mein Herz. Nicht etwa Arteriosklerose oder Nikotin oder Sucthaus, sondern all diese Dinge, mein lieber Doktor, all dies ist die Ursache meiner Angina pectoris. Ich schaue die Nacht durch die Gitter und trotz der Last auf meiner Brust schlägt mein Herz mit dem allerfernsten Gestirn.
Passport in Arabic, جواز السفر. لم يعرفني في الزلال التي تمتس لؤوني في جواز السفر وكان جلاهي عنده معدنا لساح يعشنك جمال الصوار. لم يعرفني أهتتك كفي بلا شمس لأن الجسر يعرفني تعرفني كل أغاني المطر. لا تتاكني شهيبا كالقمر كل الأسافر التي لحقت كفن على باب المطار البعيد كل حقول القهم كل السجون كل القبور البيض كل الأحد لأن المندلي التي لوحت كل أعيون كانت معي لكنهم قد أسقحتها من جواز السفر. أرمن الاسم من الانتماء في تراتب ربتها بالأليدين أيب سهالا يوم ما لا أسمها لا تجعلوني إبارة مارة يا سادتي الأنبياء لا تسألوا الأسخار أم أسمها لا تسألوا الوديء أن أمها من جبهتي ينشق صوف الدية ومن يدي ينبو ماء المهر كل قلوب الناس جنسيتي فلسق إني جواز السفر
Passport. They did not recognize me in the shadows that suck away my color in this passport. And to them, my wound was an exhibit for a tourist who loves to collect photographs. They did not recognize me. Don't leave the palm of my hand without the sun, because the trees recognize me. Don't leave me pale like the moon. All the birds that follow my palm to the door of this distant airport, all the wheat fields, all the prisons, all the white tombstones, all the barbed boundaries, all the waving handkerchiefs, all the eyes were with me, but they dropped them from my passport. Stripped of my name and identity, on a soil I nourished with my own hands, today Job cried out, filling the sky, don't make an example of me again. O gentlemen, prophets, don't ask the trees for their names. Don't ask the valleys who their mother is. From my forehead burst the sword of light, and from my hand springs the water of the river. All the hands of the people are my identity, so take away my passport.
Der Gefangene wünscht der Tod, meinem lieben Zellennachbar, fällt ihn hartig. Der Gefangene spricht, ich denke deinen Namen, Tod, und um mich bricht der Zellenbau und Trümmer. Fundamente liegen bloß, auf Pfosten reisen sie die schweren Eisengitter los und krümmen sich in maskenlosen, starren Licht. In meiner Seele gilt ein Schrei, ein Zittern wird verschüchterte Gebärde ins Blut, darin das Leben pochen schmeckt. Und wie die Kreisende sich und ihr Junges ringt, so ringt mein Blut verzweifelt den Feld der Erde. O dass ich fliehe konnte, denn der hilflos hingegeben, heißt hilflos sich zu zerstören. Wer sich aufgibt, wählt dich zum Freund. Ich aber will das Leben. Ich will das Leben so, dass mich das Leben liebt und seinen Rhythmus durch mich strömt. Mich filterfluten, des trunkene Erdenlust nicht tausend Jahre stilten.
Der Tod spricht, da du das Leben willst, warum erbleichen, wenn meine Melodie in deiner Seele tönt? Wer mich ertrankt, der atmet wie der Sand. Sein Herz kann nicht mehr grelle Klang erriechen. Ist tot der Baum im Herbst, der Abendweiten? Ist tot die Blume, deren Blutfallen sich erfüllt? Ist tot die schwarze Stein, der Glüten Kraft erholt? Ist tot die Erde über Raben, menschliche Geseite? Oh, sie belangen dich. Auch ich bin Leben. Einmal sprachen sie, der Tod sei in der Welt. Ich bin das Ewige im Spiel der Formen, die wollen die Umwelt weben. Dem einen mehr, das den Sinn in Handen hält, ich bin der Wanderer, der irgendwann die tiefsten Wunden. Und wer mich fand, der hat den Schoß der Welt gefunden.
Prisoner in death, to my dear cellmate, Walter Patek. The prisoner says, I think your name, death, and it kills me. The cell block in ruins, foundations laid bare. The heavy iron rails rip themselves loose from their jams and warp in the maskless, numb light. My soul emits a cry. A shiver casts a frightened gesture into the blood where the throbbing life is, and how mother struggles for herself and her young. So my blood grapples desperately for the source of the earth. Oh, that I could flee. If you helplessly gave up, you're helplessly destroying yourself. Who gives up chooses you as a friend. but I want to live. I want life so for life to love me. And as a rhythm streams through me, me word filled by the drunken earth lust that hasn't slacked 1,000 years.
Death says, since you want life, why all your power? Once my melody chimes in your soul. He who bears me breathes as if reconciled, his heart no longer reached by garish sound. Is the tree dead in autumn of evening's expanse? Is the flower dead whose bosom fulfills itself falling? Is the black stone dead that shrouds its ember forces? Is the earth dead above graves of human tides? Alas, how they lied to you. Too am life. A fairy tale is what they told you of death being in the world. I am eternity in the play of forms that weave perfection. Nigh, the one that holds his hands all sense. I am the wanderer who overcomes the deepest wounds, and he who found me has found the bosom of the world.
把牢底坐穿，作者何敬平。为了免除下一代的苦难，我们愿把这牢底坐穿。这是个混乱的日子，黑夜被人硬当作白天，在人们的头上狂舞的人享福了，在深沉的夜里，他们飞旋于红灯绿酒之间。呼天的人是有罪的，据说天是不应该被人呼喊，而他的位置却是在他们脚底下面。牢狱果真是为善良的人们而设的吗？为什么大家的幸福被少数人强夺霸占？我们是天生的叛逆者，我们要把这颠倒的乾坤扭转，我们要把不合理的一切打翻。今天我们坐牢了，坐牢有什么稀罕？为了免除下一代的苦难，我们愿把这牢底坐穿。1948年夏，于渣滓洞。
Above people's heads, crazy dancers enjoy the benefits. In deep nights, they fly between neon lights and wine. People who shout at heaven are guilty of crime. It is believed that heaven is not supposed to be shouted at, yet its location is under their feet. Is prison really for people who are kind? Why is our happiness usurped by a few? Born rebels, we want to turn back from chaos, to overthrow all that is rotten. Today, we are in prison. But what is rare or new in that? To spare the next generation misery, we will gladly wear through the prison floor.
What thou lovest well remains, the rest is dross. What thou lovest well shall not be reft from thee, What thou lovest well is thy true heritage. Whose world, or mine, or theirs, or is it of none? First came the seen, then thus the palpable, Elysium, though it were in the halls of hell. What thou lovest well is thy true heritage. What thou lovest well shall not be reft from thee. The ant's a centaur in his dragon world. Pull down thy vanity. It is not man made courage, or made order, or made grace. Pull down thy vanity, I say, pull down. Learn of the green world what can be thy place. In scaled invention or true artistry. Pull down thy vanity, Pacquin, pull down. The green cask has outdone your elegance.
Was du wirklich liebst, bleibt. Was du von Herzen liebst, bleibt, das übrige ist Müll. Was du von Herzen liebst, wird dir nicht entrissen. Was du von Herzen liebst, ist deine wahre Erbschaft. Wem gehört die Welt? Mir oder ihnen oder niemandem? Zuerst kann das Sichtbar, darauf dann das Griffbar. Elysium. Obwohl noch im Bereich der Hölle, was du von Herzen liebst, ist deine wahre Erbschaft. Was du von Herzen liebst, wird dir nicht entrissen. Die Ameise ist ein Kentor in ihrer Drachenwelt. Reiß dich los von der Eitelkeit. Es war nicht der Mensch, der den Mut machte, oder die Ordnung, oder die Anmut. Reiß dich los von der Eitelkeit, sag ich, reiß dich los. Lerne von der grünen Welt, wo du hingehörst. Im Maß wollen erfinden oder in der wahren Kunst, reiß dich los von der Eitelkeit. Pacon, reiß dich los. Der grüne Helm hat deine Eleganz übertroffen.
Prisão. Nesta cidade, quatro mulheres estão no cárcere. Apenas quatro. Uma na cela que dá para o rio, uma na cela que dá para o monte, outra na cela que dá para a igreja, e a última na do cemitério ali embaixo. Apenas quatro. 40 mulheres noutra cidade, 40 ao menos, estão no cárcere. 10 voltadas para as espumas, 10 para a lua movediça, 10 para pedras sem resposta, 10 para espelhos enganosos. Em celas de ar, de água, de vidro, estão presas 40 mulheres, 40 ao menos naquela cidade. 400 mulheres, 400, digo, estão presas, 100 por ódio, sem por amor, sem por orgulho, sem por desprezo, em celas de ferro, em celas de fogo, em celas sem ferro nem fogo, somente de dor e silêncio. 400 mulheres numa outra cidade, 400, digo, estão presas. 4.000 mulheres no cárcere, e 4.000.000, já nem sei a conta, em cidades que não se dizem, em lugares que ninguém sabe. Estão presas, estão para sempre, sem janela e sem esperança. Umas voltadas para o presente, outras para o passado, e as outras para o futuro, e o resto sem futuro, passado ou presente. Presas em prisão giratória, presas em delírio, na sombra, presas por outros e por si mesmas. Tão presas que ninguém as solta. E nem o rubro galo do sol, nem a andorinha azul da lua podem levar qualquer recado à prisão por onde as mulheres se convertem em sal e muro.
In this town, four women are in jail. Only four. One in the cell facing the river, one in the cell facing the mountain, one in the cell facing the church, and the last one in the cell facing the cemetery, below over there. Only four. 40 women in another town, 40 at least, are in jail. 10 facing the surf, 10 facing the moving moon, 10 the stones without answers, 10 the deceiving mirrors. Within cells of air, water, and glass, 40 women are jailed in, at least 40 in that town. 400 women, 400 I say, are in jail. 100 by hate, 100 by love, 100 by pride, 100 by scorn, in iron cells, in fire cells, in cells without iron nor fire, only pain and silence. 400 women in another town, 400, I say, are in jail. 4,000 women in jail, and 4 million, and I do not even know the total anymore, in places that no one knows or jailed in forever, without a window, without hope, some of them facing the present, others facing the past, the others facing the future. And the remainder without future, past, or present, jailed in revolving prisons, imprisoned in delirium, in shadows, imprisoned by others and by themselves, so strongly imprisoned that no one can free them, and neither the red rooster, the sun, nor the blue swallow, the moon, can bring any message to this prison where the women convert themselves into salt and wall.
Le ciel est par-dessus le toit, et écrit par Paul Vellin pendant son incarcération à Mons en Belgique. En effet, ce célèbre poète français du 19e siècle a été condamné à 2 ans de prison parce qu'il avait tenté d'assassiner son amant d'Arthur Rimbaud, lui aussi poète.
The sky is above the roof. The poem we are going to read is entitled The Sky is Above the Roof. It was written by Paul Verlaine during his incarceration in Mons, Belgium. Indeed, this famous French poet of the 19th century was sentenced to 2 years in prison because he attempted to murder his lover, Arthur Rimbaud, also a poet.
Le ciel est par-dessus le toit, si bleu, si calme, un arbre par-dessus le toit, beurre sapin, la cloche dans le ciel qu'on voit, doucement teinte. Un oiseau sur l'arbre qu'on voit chante sa plante. Mon Dieu, la vie est là, simple et tranquille. Cette paisible rumeur-là vient de la ville. Qu'as-tu fait, ô toi que voilà, pleurante sans cesse? Dis, qu'as-tu fait, toi que voilà, de ta jeunesse?
The sky above the roof is so blue, so calm. A tree above the roof sways its fronds. The bell in the sky we see softly chimes. A bird in the tree we see sings its lament. Dear God, life is there, simple and still. That peaceful murmur there comes from the town. What have you done? You who are here, weeping endlessly. Oh, what have you done, you who are here, with the days of your youth?
Le ciel est par-dessous le toit, si bleu, si calme.
aus meinem rauchenden Blut wird etwas entspringen, das kann einen Tag die Welt retten. Jedes Gefühl in mir haben sie ausgeräuchert. Ich weiß nicht, was warm oder kalt oder blau ist. Ich höre einen einzigen hohen Ton, auch wenn die Musik nicht angeht. Ich sehe Tränengrau, wo die anderen Farben. Ich denke nichts, solange will ich nichts denken, bis die Schmach weggenommen, getilgt ist, bis die Beschimpfungen genommen sind von mir. Man hätte mit mir, mit jeder meiner Zellen, eine Himmelfahrt machen können. Das Messopfer auf meinen Wunden, auf meiner Brust, die Litanei der Bitten und Vergebung ist noch nicht dargebracht. Ich sage euch, und nicht durch Blumen, dass die Litanei fehlt und dass ich warte auf den Kniefall und die Gerechtigkeit und dass ein Freispruch nur von mir kommen kann. Oh, wie richt ich, wie habe ich gerichtet, 300, eine Million Minuten und kommen 300 Tage und immer neue Tage und ich gebe nicht frei, was mich nicht frei gibt, spreche nicht frei, was mich tagtäglich, nachtnächtlich zur Leidenschaft verurteilt.
My cell. Where the others have a body, I had genius. From my smoking blood, something will spring, which one day can save the world. They have smoked out every feeling inside me. I don't know what warm or cold or blue is. I hear a single high tone, even when no music plays. I see the gray of tears where others see colors. I think of nothing, and I want to think of nothing until the shame is taken away, eradicated. Until the insults are taken away from me. One could have made each of my cells into a place of ascension, the sacrificial mass consisting of my wounds upon my breast, the litany of prayer, and yet forgiveness is not granted. I say to you all, and not through flowers, that the litany is missing, and I await the bended knee and justice, and that an acquittal can only come from me. Oh, how I judge, how I have judged 300, a million minutes, and still 300 days, and always new days, and I don't let go of what won't let go of me, nor acquit that which day after day, night after night, condemns me to such rage.
Ahora me come. Ahora siento como suben y tiran de las uñas. Oigo su roer llegamente hasta los huesos. Tierra me echan tierra. Bailan, bailan sobre este montón de tierra y piedra que me cubre. Me aplastan y vituperan, repitiendo no sé qué aberrante resolución de me atañe. Me han sepultado. Han danzado sobre mí, han apisonado bien el suelo. Se han ido dejándome bien muerto y enterrado. Este es mi momento.
Now they eat me. Now I feel them rising and pulling on my nails. I hear his gnawing reaching down to my bones. Dirt. They throw up dirt at me. They dance. They dance on this pile of earth and stone that covers me. They cry.
dulce amante, que la amistad no detenga sus pasos en mis umbrales, ni la golondrina el vuelo, ni el amor sus labios, nadie. Mi casa y mi corazón, nunca cerrados, que pasen los pájaros, los amigos, y el sol y el aire.
My house, my heart, dream of freedom. If I go out into life one day, my house will have no keys, always open, like the sea, the sun, and the air. Let day, night, and day enter, and the blue rain, the evening, the red bread of dawn, the moon, my sweet lover. May friendship not halt its steps at my threshold, nor the swallow its flight, nor the love its lips. No one, my house and my heart, never close. Let the birds pass, the friends, the sun, and the air.
Derrota, fragmento de Rafael Cadenas. Yo que he tenido nunca un oficio, que ante todo competidor me he sentido débil, que perdí los mejores títulos para la vida, que apenas llego a un sitio ya quiero ir, creyendo que mudarme es una solución, que he sido negado anticipadamente y escarnecido por los más aptos, que me arrimo a las paredes para no caer del todo, que soy objeto de risa para mí misma, que creí que mi padre era eterno, que he sido humillado por profesores de literatura, que un día pregunté en qué podía ayudar y la respuesta fue una risotada, que no podré nunca formar un hogar, ni ser brillante, ni triunfar en la vida, que he sido abandonado por muchas personas porque casi no amo, que tengo vergüenza por actos que no he cometido.
A fragment of the poem Defeat. I, who have never had a trade, who before any competitor have felt weak, who have lost the best qualifications for life, who as soon as I arrive at a place already want to leave, thinking that moving is a solution, who have been denied in advance and scoffed at by the fitter, who lean on walls so as not to fall down, who am an object of laughter to myself, who believe my father was eternal, who have been humiliated by professors of literature, who asked one day what I could do to help, and the answer was a guffaw, who will never be able to set up a home, nor be brilliant, nor triumph in life, who have been deserted by many people because I hardly speak, who am ashamed of acts I didn't commit.
Octubre 1976 de Ana María Ponce. Y si de vos me dijeran que no exististe, les gritaría que me quedan tus ojos tristes, tu caminar lento, tu sonrisa apenas gozada, tu caricia leve y una espera, una larga espera de la que no volveremos nunca, o tal vez sí.
October 1976. And if they told me that you didn't exist, I would yell at them that I still have. Your sad eyes, your slow walk, your barely sketched smile, your light caress, and a wait, a long wait, from which we will never return, or maybe we will. October 1976.
L'amour qui m'accompagne prendra en pitié surtout ma débile raison et cet espoir qui
It was written by Guillaume Apollinaire, a famous French poet of the 20th century, during his incarceration at the Santé prison in Paris from September 7th to 12th, 1911. Indeed, Apollinaire was accused of being an accomplice of Gerty Pierre, who had stolen the Mona Lisa from the Louvre Museum. How bored I am between their wall and wall, whose color pales and pines. A fly on the paper with extremely small steps runs across these lines. What will become of me, O God who knows, my pain who gave it me. Have pity on my dry eyes and my pallor, my chair which creaks and is not free. And all these poor hearts beating in this prison and love beside me seated. Pity above all my unstable reason and this despair which threatens to defeat it.
Chanson tokenise. Par le poète tokenise, vanteuil un charretier. Par le poète tokenise, veut sortir un va-nu-pied. Et les gars de la ville courent sus au va-nu-pied. Qu'importe-tu de la ville? J'y laisse mon cœur entier. Et les gars de la ville courent sus au charretier. Qu'importe-tu dans la ville? Mon cœur pour me marier. Que de cœur dans tokenise. Les gardes rièrent, va-nu-pied la route église, l'amour grise au charretier. Les beaux gardes de la ville tricotaient superbement, puis les portes de la ville se fermèrent lentement.
Through the gates of Orkanese, a wagoner wants to enter. Through the gates of Orkanese, a vagabond wants to leave. And the sentries guarding the town rush up to the vagabond. What are you taking from the town? I'm leaving my whole heart behind. And the sentries guarding the town rush up to the wagoner. What are you carrying into the town? My heart, in order to marry. So many hearts in Orkanese. The sentries laughed and laughed. Vagabond, the road's not merry. Love makes you merry, O wagoner. The handsome sentries guarding the town knitted vaingloriously. The gates of the town then slowly closed.
Hôtel. Ma chambre a la forme d'une cage. Le soleil passe son bras par la fenêtre. Mais moi qui veux fumer pour faire des mirages, j'allume au feu du jour ma cigarette. Je ne veux pas travailler, je veux fumer.
Hôtel. My room is shaped like a cage. The sun slips its arm through the window. But I, who want to smoke, make mirages. I light my cigarette on daylight's fire. I do not want to work. I want to smoke.
Por favor.
tremito che muore, voce stanca, voce smarrita, col tremito del batticuore, voce di una corsa anelante che al povero petto s'afferra per dir tante cose e poi tante, ma piena alla bocca di terra. Tante, tante cose che vuole che io sappia, ricordi, sì, sì, ma di tante, tante parole non sento che un soffio, svanì. Quando avevo tanto bisogno di pane e di compassione, che mangiavo solo nel sogno, svegliandomi al primo boccone, una notte, sulla spalletta del reno coperta di neve, dritto e solo, passava in fretta, l'acqua brontolando, si beve, dritto e solo, con un gran pianto, da bere a finire così, mi sentii d'un tratto d'accanto, quel soffio di voce svanì. Oh, la terra, com'è cattiva, la terra che amari bocconi, ma voleva dirmi, io capiva, no, no, di le devozioni. Le dicevi con me, pian piano, con sempre la voce più bassa, la tua mano nella mia mano, ridille, vedrai che ti passa. Non far piangere, piangere, piangere, ancora chi tanto soffrì. Il tuo pane, prega il tuo angelo che te lo porti, svanì. Una notte dalle lunghe ore, nel carcere che all'improvviso, dissi, avresti molto dolore, tu se non t'avessero ucciso. Ora, o babbo, che il mio pensiero, dal carcere con un lamento, vide il babbo nel cimitero, le pie sorelline in convento, e che agli uomini la mia vita volevo lasciarla lì, risentì la voce smarrita che disse in un soffio, svanì. Oh, la terra, com'è cattiva, non lascia di scorrere poi, ma voleva dirmi, io capiva, piuttosto di un requie per noi. Non possiamo nel campo santo più prendere sonno un minuto, che sentiamo struggersi in pianto le bimbe che l'hanno saputo. Oh, la mia vita che ti diedi per loro, lasciarla vuoi qui, qui, figlio mio, dove non vedi chi uccise tuo padre, svanì. Quante volte sei rivenuta nei cupi abbandoni del cuore, voce stanca, voce perduta, col tremito del batticuore, voce d'una corsa anelante che ai poveri labbri si tocca, per dir tante cose e poi tante, ma piena di terra alla bocca, la tua bocca con i tuoi baci, già tanto accorati a quei dì beati e fugaci, che aveva i tuoi baci svanì, che m'addormentavano gravi, campane col placido canto, e sul capo biondo che amavi sentivo un tepore di pianto, che ti lessi negli occhi, che erano pieni di pianto, che sono pieni di terra la preghiera, di vivere ed essere buono. Ed allora, quasi un comando, no, quasi un compianto, t'uscì, la parola che a quando mi dice anche adesso, svanì.
There's a voice in my life that I sense at the point of dying. Weary, weary voice, lost voice, with the trembling of the heartbeat. Voice of a panting arrival, clutching at the poor chest, to say so many things and then so many, but with a mouth full of earth. So many things it wants me to know, remember, yes, yes. But of so many words, I only feel a breath, Zavani. When I needed so much bread and compassion that I only ate in dreams, waking up at the first bite, one night on the embankment of the Reno, covered in snow, upright and alone, the water rushed by, murmuring, are you thirsty? Upright and alone, with a great cry of ending up like this, suddenly I felt beside me that breath of a voice, Zavani. Oh, the earth, how cruel it is, the earth with its bitter morsels. But it wanted to tell me, I understood. No, no, say the devotions. You say them with me softly, with your voice ever lower, your hand on my hand. Repeat them. You'll see it will pass. Don't make me cry, cry, cry again. One who suffered so much, your bread, pray to your angel to bring it to you. Savannah. One night of long hours in prison, when suddenly I said, you would now have much pain, Daddy, if they hadn't killed you, that my thought from the prison with a lament saw Daddy in the cemetery, the devout sisters in the convent, and that to men, my life, I wanted to leave it there. I heard again the lost voice that said in a breath, Savannah. Oh, the earth, how cruel it is. It doesn't let us converse then. But it wanted to tell me, I understood, rather say a requiem for us. We can no longer in the cemetery get a minute's sleep, as we hear the young girls who knew it sobbing away. Oh, my life that I gave you, for them, do you want to leave it here? Here, my son? Where you don't see who killed your father, Zavani? How many times you have come back to the dark abandonments of the heart, weary voice, lost voice, with the trembling of the heartbeat, voice of the panting arrival, that touches the poor lips to say so many things and then so many, but its mouth is full of earth. Your mouth, with your kisses already so afflicted in those days, in those blessed and fleeting days when I had your kisses, Zavani. Heavy bells that weighed me down with their tranquil chant. On the beloved blonde head, I felt a warmth of tears that I read in your eyes, which were full of tears, which are full of earth, the prayer to live and to be good. And then, almost a command, no, almost a lament, you came out of you the word that from time to time you will say to me, Zavani.
Behütet und getröstet wunderbar, so will ich diese Tage mit euch leben und mit euch gehen in ein neues Jahr. Noch wird das alte unsere Hesen qualm, nach Ducht und böse Tage schwer last. Ach Herr, gibt unsere aufgeschreckten Seelen das Heil, für das du uns geschaffen hast.
Und reichst du uns den schweren Kelch, den bittern, des Leids und gefüllt bis an den höchsten Rand. So nehmen wir in Dankbar und in Zittern auf deiner guten und geliebten Hand. Doch willst du uns noch einmal Freunde schenken und die Welt mit ihrer Sonne glanz. Dann wollen wir des vergangenen gedenken und dann gehört dir unser Leben ganz.
Lass warm und hell die Kirchen heute flammen, die du in unserer Dunkelheit gebracht, für wenn es sein kann, wieder uns zusammen. Wir wissen es, dein Licht schitten und der Nacht. Wenn sich die Stille nun tief um uns beteiligt, so lass uns heulen jenen wollen klar. Der Welt, die unsichtbar sich um uns verteilt, all deiner Kinder heulen Lobgesang.
Von guten Mächten wunderbar gebogen, erwarten wir getrost, was kommen mag. Gott ist bei uns am Abend und am Morgen und ganz gewiss an jedem neuen Tag.
By loving forces silently surrounded, I feel quite soothed, secure, and filled with grace. So I would like to live these days together and go with you into another year. Still, matters of the past are pressing our hearts, and evil days are weighing down on us. O Lord, to our souls, so scared and sore, give rescue, as it's that you made us for. And when you pass to us the bitter chalice, filled with suffering to the brim and more, we take it, full of thanks and trembling not, from this your caring and beloved hand. But if you want to please us over and again with our shining sun and wondrous world, let us muse on what is past, and then we shall, with our lives in all, belong to you. Warm and bright be our candle's flame today, since into gloom you brought a gleaming light, and lead us again, if you will, together. We know it, you are a beaming in the night. When silence now will snow around us everywhere, so let us hear the all-embracing sound of greater things than we can see and wider, your world and all your children's soaring hail. By loving forces wonderfully sheltered, we are waiting fearlessly what comes. God is with us at dusk and in the morning, and most assuredly on every day.
Ach, in mein was. Ach, in mein was, in mein. Wo die warmen Lüfte wehen, wo verliebte Leute pflegen, ihren Liebchen nachzugehen. Ich allein, ich armer Trauriger, lieg im Kerker so verschmachtet. Und ich seh nicht, wann es taget, und ich weiß nicht, wann es nachtet. Nur an einem Vöglein merk ich's, dass da draußen mein sein. Das hat mir ein Schütz getötet. Geb ihm Gott den schlimmsten Dank.
Ah, in May it was, in Maytime, when warm breezes blow, when those in love are wont to seek their loves. I alone, sad wretch, languish in a dungeon cell, and cannot tell when day dawns, and cannot tell when night falls. Only one little bird could tell me, that sang out there in May. A hunter killed it. May God give him the worst of rewards.
Thank you.
frammenti assetate di verdi prati e colorati fiori. Su e giù, tra il dischiudersi di rumorosi, inutili assorde e pesanti porte. Un passo, due passi. Su e giù, tra idee mirabolanti e spazi sempre uguali. Su e giù, tra un passato ormai passato e un futuro tardo a far dire. Su e giù, inseguire sogni ormai, logri, vani, sveniti, finiti, boi, assorti. Un passo, due passi. Su e giù, verso assili, desidere di un viaggio senza ritorno. Su e giù, tra un vivere tormentato da oro di luce. Su e giù, tra lo schiarir di grigia aurora che par sempre quella. Un passo, due passi. Su e giù, in attesa di un sorriso, richiamo all'amor passato. Su e giù, in attesa di un sì che schiuda porte alle mie dolori. Su e giù, verso un tramanto grigio, cupo, amaro, triste. Un passo, due passi. Su e giù verso bianche spiagge letti a morir d'onde. Su e giù verso sorrisi sogni di notti a parir giorni. Su e giù verso vita nuova a colorare la mente. Un passo, due passi. E poi un passo ancora. E poi due passi ancora.
Madness. One step, two steps. Up and down among crumbling and dripping walls. Up and down among minds thirsty for green meadows and colorful flowers. Up and down among the opening of noisy, useless, absurd, and heavy doors. One step, two steps. Up and down among marvelous ideas and always identical spaces. Up and down between a past now gone and a future late to arrive. Up and down chasing dreams now worn out, vain, exhausted, finished, dark, absurd. One step, two steps. Up and down towards the tormenting desires of a journey with no return. Up and down between a life tormented by the horror of light. Up and down between the clearing of gray dawn that always seems the same. One step, two steps. Up and down waiting for a smile, a call to love's past. Up and down waiting for a yes to open doors to soothe the pains. Up and down towards a gray, dark, bitter, sad sunset. One step, two steps. Up and down towards white beaches, beds to die from waves. Up and down towards smiles, dreams of nights giving birth to days. Up and down towards a new life to color the mind. One step, two steps, and then one more step, and then two more steps.
Sur une tasse en prison, d'Eugène Delacroix, par Charles Baudelaire. Le poète au cachot, débraillé, maladif, roulant un manuscrit sous son pied convulsif, mesure d'un regard que la terreur enflamme l'escalier de vertige où s'abîme son âme. Les rires enivrantes ont s'emplit la prison, vers l'étrange et l'absurde invite sa raison. Le doute l'environne et la peur ridicule, hideuse et multiforme, autour de lui circule. Ce génie enfermé dans un taudis malsain, ses grimaces, ses cris, ses spectres dont l'essaim tourbillonne, ameuté derrière son oreille, ce rêveur que l'horreur de son logis réveille, voilà bien ton emblème, âme songe obscur, que le réel étouffe entre ses quatre mains.
Tasso in prison, the poet in the asylum, unkempt, weak, rolls a manuscript beneath trembling feet. Beset with vertigo, inflamed with terror, his soul sinks like a ball down an empty stair. Mocking laughter fills his prison cell, strange and absurd, replace reason for a swell of doubt surrounding, apprehension, fear, all multiform, hideous, and circular. Genius is imprisoned in this place of harm. Grimaces gather, phantom specters swarm. They cry and swirl and wheel behind his ear. Dreamer awakened by screams and hoarder's alarm. This the soul's emblem, your clouded dreams transformed between four walls that reality stifles here.
Ai tempi delle piccole prigioni, io ami un compagno, un povraccio senza santità. E così da questo amore infelice sei nata tu, fiore del mio pensiero. Nessuno in manicomio ha mai dato un bacio, se non al muro che lo opprimeva. E questo vuol dire che la santità, e di tutti come di tutti, l'amore.
In the times of the useless prison, I loved a companion, a poor man without sanctity. And so from this unhappy love, you were born, flower of my thoughts. No one in the asylum has ever given a kiss except to the wall that oppressed him. And this means that sanctity is for everyone, as love is for everyone.
Wollen flög over Muren. Die Westen säften, für jetzt fremde Tiden in die Snackere Lung. Verstave de Lief. Schönheiten quarle wer, som tatuerker. Ner rümmeren Krebs war man fickerne Fulra mit Kantarelle. Bergstarnes dann, auch war turnene Stungesteg, förbrillade skogen. Porten glider upp, vi står på anstaltsgården i en ny årstid. Murens lampor tänds, nattflygalen ser en fläck av orklig ljus. Natt. En lantradare går förbi, internernas drömmar i dörren. Porten dricker mjölk, och somna tryck i sin cell, en moder av sten.
Prison, 11 aside, sudden dismay, the ball's gone, right over the wall.
More noise than need be, just to startle time into getting a move on.
Wrongly spelled those lies, loveliness remains the way tattoo marks remain.
When the runaway was caught, he gathered pockets full of shenterings. Din from the workshops and the watchtower's heavy steps reflects the forest.
The tall doors swing back. We're inside the prison yard in a new season.
The wall lamps are lit. The night flyer sees a smudge of unreal brightness.
An enormous truck rumbles past at night. The dreams of inmates tremble.
The boy drinks milk and sleeps securely in a cell, a mother of stone.
Bird feels, alas, when the sun is bright on the upland slopes, when the wind stirs soft through the springing grass, and the river flows like a stream of glass, when the first bird sings and the first bud opes and the faint perfume from its chalice steals, I know what the caged bird feels.
I know why the caged bird beats his wing till its blood is red on the cruel bars. For he must fly back to his perch and cling when he would fain be on the bough a swing. And a pain still throbs in the old, old scars, and they pulse again with a keener sting. I know why he beats his wing.
I know why the caged bird sings, ah me, when his wing is bruised and his bosom sore. When he beats his bars and he would be free, it is not a carol of joy or glee, but a prayer that he sends from his heart's deep core, but a plea that upward to heaven he flings. I know why the caged bird sings.
Thank you.